Does Jack Hughes have the potential to be a top five player in the NHL? And is he faster than Connor McDavid at the next level? Let's talk about it next. Welcome back to Hockey Scouting Report. So glad you're here. So glad you're watching. Today's video, Jack Hughes, the number one draft pick in the 2019 NHL entry draft. And we'll know just in a matter of hours, just a couple hours right now, who is going to be selecting Jack Hughes. We'll know based on who wins that lottery. But Jack Hughes, clearly a very talented player. He's an American, only 17 years old, the birthday May 14th. So definitely on the younger side, but able to really do great things in the USDP program, both this year as a 17-year-old, but also last year as a 16-year-old, playing also at the World Juniors under 20 this year as a 17-year-old. What a great showing we have seen. So before we get into the content, make sure to hit that thumbs up. Of course, subscribe for more content. And I will also be releasing, right after the lottery, a recap of the lottery and an analysis of what teams are going to be doing what based on how they moved in the lottery. So let's get right into it. And if you enjoy it, make sure to subscribe and also check out my Twitter at Hockey Levine. So Jack Hughes, like I said, 17 years old, 5'10", 168. So clearly size is being seen as less of an impactful thing in the NHL, as really what it comes down to is, do you have great stick and puck skills? Are you very skilled overall? Do you have great speed and great skating? Jack Hughes oozes all of these. We're talking about elite level skating. We're talking about McDavid, McKinnon, this kind of level of speed. But he also brings very good vision from the back end, very shifty, great hands, and many other attributes I'll get into. This is why he's such an elite prospect. Now, of course, he was the captain of the USDP program this year, 41 games played, 23 goals, 63 assists. Really see the great playmaking that he brings. And then 86 points overall, only 18 penalty minutes. This is not someone that really plays in a way where they're going to be getting a lot of penalty minutes. Certainly, he can play with that edge, but only being 5'10", he's not really a physical player. That's not part of his game. Strength is definitely something that he could continue to work on in his game, but overall, very skilled player. What we really want to be talking about is how great his hockey IQ is, his elite level of speed, how great his skating is, and how he's able to play at that high level when he's skating at such a high speed. And if we dive deep on who he was playing with this year to see how talented it was, well, obviously he had Trevor Zegras, Cole Caulfield, Matthew Boldy, Alex Turcotte, but then also Cam York, and then on the goaltending, Spencer Knight as well as Cameron Rowe. Very talented prospects. We're looking at multiple first-round picks just alone in terms of his line mates. We look at Zegras, 54 games played, 26 goals, 52 assists, 78 points, also 92 penalty minutes. Definitely brings the physicality, but we see how they were able to work so well together. Very similar in the goals category, Hughes still having 11 more assists, clearly making a very impactful playmaking ability, but we see Caulfield with those 54 goals, very similar to Oliver Wahlstrom last year, having an elite level of goals. This is what Jack Hughes brings to any system. He's someone that, yes, can put up a decent amount of goals himself at the next level. We're talking probably 25 to 30 goals, but this is someone that can easily be in a 70 assist point person, someone who is going to make that sniper, that power forward near you much better. And so when we talk about teams that potentially could slide up to select Jack Hughes, whether that's the Canucks finally having that luck back from ninth, whether that's the Red Wings coming up, well, these teams do have snipers. And if you have someone like Hughes with someone like Brock Besser, or Hughes with someone like Philip Zadina, this is what you're adding to a system. You're adding an elite-level passer who can make that sniper go from a 25 to 30-goal scorer to someone who can easily do 40 goals. We see this with Caulfield. We see this with Wahlstrom. Wahlstrom this year in the NCAA definitely had his struggles. He has turned pro since. But having those struggles, we see that Wahlstrom, yes, is a very talented prospect. But without Jack Hughes, it's been tough for him. We look at someone like Matthew Boldy, also on the USDP program, that second liner, 30 goals, 39 assists, 69 points. And we see Alex Turcotte, 23 goals, 30 assists. Very talented players, but in terms of who plays with Jack Hughes, their stats are clearly elevated. Last year, we saw it was Farabee Wahlstrom, but also on the defense, Keandre Miller, Matias Samuelson, Jake Weiss on that second line centering spot. I did scouting reports on all of those players last year. Feel free to check them out. But Jack Hughes clearly elevated all those players. We look at Jack Hughes' numbers last year, only a 16-year-old, 36 games played, 27 goals, 41 assists, 68 points. His stats last year were as good as the Trevor Zegras, Cole Caulfield, Matthew Boldy types in terms of overall point-per-game production. Obviously not in terms of the goals like Cole Caulfield, But seeing a 16-year-old being able to play at the level of someone like a Trevor Zegras, who's trying to make that NHL level in that draft year, Jack Hughes clearly is an elite-level prospect. This year proves it even more, over a point every, 2 points every game over that amount. Like I said, 86 points, 41 games. But he also played in the USHL this year, 24 games, played 48 points, 12 goals, 36 assists. So like I said, we definitely see him playing over 2 points per game. But let's also look at what he did internationally last year, and then we'll look at it this year. Well, last year, World Junior Championship under 18, 7 games played, 5 goals, 7 assists, 12 points. Definitely made his name known here. We've known for the past 2 years that this would be the Jack Hughes draft. Similarly, we knew about Nolan Patrick 2 years before his draft. Obviously, Quinn Hughes, his brother, bringing the hype as well. And we see their brother down a few years from now, the defender Luke Hughes, could be very interesting as well. But Jack Hughes, after that year in the World Juniors under 18, he continued on this year to be even at a higher level. World Juniors under 20, keep in mind only 17 years old, 4 games played, 4 assists. No goals, but to see 4 assists from a 17-year-old who is 5'10", 168, with guys that are 19 years old, what an accomplishment for him. He got to play with Ryan Poehling. As we know, Montreal Canadiens stepped up in his first game ever. 3 goals, got that hat trick, but also the shootout winner. What an elite talent for them. Looks to be a great two-way player. But Jack Hughes also got to play with Jason Robertson, Josh Norris, of course, Joel Farabee and Oliver Wallstrom once again, his brother Quinn Hughes, and then, of course, Keandre Miller and Matthias Samuelsson once again. So Jack Hughes does have this chemistry with multiple players. It has already been developed for these guys. And so if Hughes ends up going to someone like the Buffalo Sabres, if they win the lottery, he already has that familiarity with someone like Matthias Samuelsson. But Jack Hughes has really proven over time how elite he truly is at that international stage. World Hockey Championship under 17 last season, 6 games played, 5 goals, 10 assists, 15 points. Keep in mind, only 2 penalty minutes. We also saw only 2 at the World Juniors under 18. This is someone that does not take penalty minutes, someone that overall plays a very clean game, not a physical game. He was the 8th overall selection in the OHL priority selection of 2017. Obviously, he was not going to be going to the OHL, but we see players that are elite-level players often selected by these teams, whether that's the KHL, which selected Jack Eichel, Connor McDavid. But you never know what's going to happen. On the off chance they go somewhere, you want to have those selections. And so the OHL did that selection with Jack Hughes. We see this with elite-level talents. Definitely shows how talented Jack Hughes is. But let's also compare Jack Hughes' numbers when he was in the USDP program under 17. He played 27 games, played 21 goals, 33 assists, 54 points. So he's always been a step over everyone else, whether he's been 15 with the 17-year-olds, 16 with the 18-year-olds, 17 with the 20-year-olds. Jack Hughes has always played above and beyond what his age is, considering his size especially. But let's also compare this, before we get into everything else that he brings in his game in terms of attributes, let's compare this to Austin Matthews. Austin Matthews, when he was 17 years old, the year before his draft, we know his draft year, he went to the NLA, Zurich Lions. Austin Matthews, though, that 17-year-old USDP, assistant captain, 60 games played, 55 goals, 62 assists, 117 points. What an amazing showing for him. We see overall point per game, Austin Matthews slightly less than what Jack Hughes brought this year, decent amount less. But in terms of the goals, clearly many goals for Austin Matthews, 55 and 60 versus Jack Hughes is 23 and 41. So overall, Jack Hughes definitely better in terms of the assists per game on the overall stat side of that. But we see very similar comparisons in terms of what Jack Hughes had to work with. He's had in his system Wallstrom, Farabee, Zegras, Caulfield, Boldy, Turcotte. We see all these guys. Austin Matthews did as well. He got to play with Matthew Tkachuk, Jeremy Bracco, Jack Roslovic, Christian Fisher, Colin White, Troy Terry. We see all these players. What elite players. What great prospects they are. Jordan Greenway, Luke Cunningham, Charlie McAvoy, Tage Thompson, Clayton Keller, and then also 2 games and 4 games from Max Jones and Ryan Donato. So we see very similar systems. The USDP program is a system that has always developed elite-level talents, and we see just from that roster that Austin Matthews was with, at least half of that roster, a good 10 names, are NHL impactful players or soon-to-be impactful players, especially from guys like Thompson and Jones who haven't really shown it yet. And so we see this year, the system that Jack Hughes has been playing with, probably 3 years from now, we'll be hearing these names all the time as regular NHLers, Zegras, Caulfield, Boldy, guys like Wallstrom, guys like Farabee. And so let's look at what Jack Hughes also brings in terms of attributes. The stats are off the charts. In fact, nobody has had more points than Jack Hughes in a USDP career. It used to be the record by Clayton Keller. Jack Hughes now has that record. Playing as a 16-year-old, putting up numbers that are as good as many 17-year-old draft picks, 18-year-old draft picks, we see Jack Hughes doing that for sure. And so let's see what he brings. Well, really, it starts off with a great first step. Excellent acceleration. And this is what we see really from someone like Nathan MacKinnon. MacKinnon has elite level speed, one of the fastest players in the league, but he does it in large part because his first step is second to none. His acceleration is excellent, and that happens through great powerful strides and great muscle. Despite Jack Hughes having potential strength issues, it's never been an issue in terms of his steps, always pushing power through his steps. And we see with that his great acceleration, that great first step, but he's able to constantly build momentum, and he hits that top speed very quickly. We see that especially with MacKinnon, like I mentioned, able to hit that top speed very quickly. But he's also very dynamic with the puck. Everything that he does with the puck is done with finesse. Someone who has very good deke skills, someone who in that one-on-one open ice is going to make that play very quickly. And in large part because his puck skills are at an elite level, extremely shifty. Being 5'10", he's able to get into areas that oftentimes other players can't, able to get into those passing lanes very quickly. He's a very effective passer and does so with great hands. He has the hands that oftentimes you would see from a sniper, someone that's able to make great transitions in terms of their shot, but he does this oftentimes in terms of his passing. So he's able to have a great passing ability, but doing so in the form of an elite sniper. Not necessarily in terms of actually sniping, but in terms of how he's transitioning the puck, very good to see from him. He also has great edge work. He has elite level hockey IQ. And like I said, he's always done everything better than people far above his age. Very good positioning offensively and defensively. This isn't someone that we see playing on the penalty kill or defensively, but he's able to get there if there is a transitional issue. If there is a turnover, he's able to make that back check, get back there quick enough. And in large part because his skating is elite. Coming into the NHL as an 18-year-old, he will already have definitely skating that's better than at least 80% of the league. We see this just at an 18-year-old level. Once he's that 18-year-old, will certainly be there, will be elite level speed. Someone that doesn't just play with elite level speed, but shoots at elite level speed. And think about that. We know Connor McDavid is very fast. We know Sidney Crosby's fast. We know Nathan MacKinnon's fast. But McDavid is on another level where players like Yamamoto, Puljujärvi, cannot play on his wing because he is too fast. He shoots at too much of a fast level, constantly playing at that full speed. We see guys like Patrick Kane are able to play at this full speed, able to play at this highest of levels. Someone like Mikko Rantanen is able to do it with MacKinnon. Not everyone can, and so bringing that speed makes it even harder for defenders. Then keeping in mind that you're only 5'10", you don't play with that power forward mentality in terms of driving to the net, pushing to the net, but he does this with all his steps. He constantly pushes power through him. And so Jack Hughes, despite being small, has the great speed, skating, agility, and stick handling of these undersized players like Johnny Gaudreau, but then he also has the power behind him, the dynamic behind him, the hands and the passing, like someone who is 6'4 and a power forward. And so Jack Hughes really brings everything to his game. And so what is his potential? What's really a franchise level number one center? Now, I've seen a lot of videos that like to claim that Jack Hughes is generational. In my opinion, there's no way. As good as he is, that's a term that is being way too overused. You have to definitely reserve that for players that truly are once in a generation. We're not even sure if Alexis Lafreniere is that next guy, but he is being touted as generational. But Jack Hughes is definitely a franchise-level number one center. And when we talk about that, we mean guys like Barkov, MacKinnon, McDavid, Stamkos. You know, these guys that are clear number one centers for their system. This is what Jack Hughes will be. Not only will he be a top six center from day one, he could be that number one center from day one. He could be a top five NHL player within 2 years, in the entire league top five within 2 years. What is his comparison? Well, in my mind, it's Patrick Kane. Now, Patrick Kane is a right winger, but like I said, Jack Hughes plays with a lot of mentality of a power forward, of a winger, of a sniper, of an elite passer, of a goal scorer. He brings everything to his game. Patrick Kane, 5'10", 176, very similar size. Both are left shots. Patrick Kane was the first overall pick in 2007, and we know he's had an elite career. Three Stanley Cups. I mentioned Jonathan Toews yesterday in the video. also having those three Stanley Cups. But Patrick Kane also has a Conn Smythe. He also has a Calder. He also has a Ted Lindsay, a Hart, and an Art Ross. So he's won basically everything that you'd want to win in the NHL. 81 games played this year. It was a career year. 44 goals, most goals in his career. 66 assists, 110 points for only 22 penalty minutes and a plus two. Very similar to Jack Hughes, an elite level passer. Also, like I said, brings that sniping ability, but very few penalty minutes. Not someone who plays in that gritty way. Not someone who plays in a physical way, a dirty way. Last year, Patrick Kane, 79 points, 82 games, 27 goals, 49 assists. So we see definitely this comparison with Jack Hughes in terms of statistics. Long-term, Jack Hughes will be a 25 to 30 goal scorer, depending how he develops on that sense. But definitely we're talking anywhere from 60 to 70 assists any season, at minimum 50-55. So definitely Patrick Kane numbers for sure. Patrick Kane has only had 100 points once in his career outside of this year, which was 2015-2016, 46 goals, 106 points, 60 assists. So definitely we can see that from Jack Hughes, probably less goals, but definitely as many assists. What's interesting about Patrick Kane is the amount of shots that he takes per season. I think this is really interesting to dive deep on. This season, Patrick Kane took 341 shots. Ovechkin, for comparison, took 338. So that's right, Patrick Kane had three more shots than Ovechkin. Tarasenko had 275. So Patrick Kane clearly over that. DeBrincat had 220. Patrick Laine had 245. So we see Ovechkin is outshooting all these snipers, but Patrick Kane is outshooting even them. And so not only is he a sniper, not only is he a shooter, he's this elite-level passer. Jack Hughes brings this, someone who will not play that physical realm, but someone who will be a 60-70 assist type player, but also bring the goals as well. Patrick Kane for the career, 903 games played, 356 goals, 582 assists for 938 points. So he's 1.04 points per game for the entire career. In the playoffs, it's 0.97 points per game. But let's also extend this to USDP numbers. Patrick Kane, the year before his draft, played in the USDP, 66 games played. For his total USDP career, 51 goals, 50 assists, 101 points for 1.53 points per game. Very good overall, but we see Jack Hughes clearly above that. 101 games played in the career, 63 goals, 139 assists, 202 points. So while he certainly played more games, and the goals very similar in terms of playing 40 more games, obviously less goals. So Patrick Kane is more of a goal scorer, but we see 50 assists, 66 games versus 139 assists in 101 games. Hughes had exactly 2.00 points per game versus Kane's 1.53. So Jack Hughes not only brings the speed, the elite level play, playing at a high level in terms of speed, having the great hands, the great passing ability, the great vision, the great skating and hockey IQ that Patrick Kane brings, somewhat of the goal scoring, but also he clearly outscores him in terms of statistics. Now, in the draft year for Patrick Kane, OHL London Knights, 58 games played, 62 goals, 83 assists, 145 points. So it's tough to compare the goals. Patrick Kane is a bit more of a goal scorer, but it's not like he's someone that always scores these 44 goals. Like I said, last year, 27 goals. Jack Hughes definitely could be in that category. And so what does Patrick Kane bring stylistically that also makes this comparison even stronger? Because that's really what matters here. Patrick Kane has elite vision. And we see that from the back end especially. He's able to see plays creating. He's able to create plays of his own, not have turnovers happen because he's able to be one step ahead. And we see a lot of that because his first step is great, a lot of power through that first step, very similar to Jack Hughes. Also, elite playmaking with great puck handling. This is someone that really can dangle very well, very good dekes, plays much larger than his size, with those powerful steps and great first step, also a good shot, very transitional in terms of his shot because of the good hands, very shifty, but also is a very good deker, brings a very good hockey IQ, and really the only issue we can see with Patrick Kane is potential strength issues. So overall, we see a lot of power in his steps, very good shot, very good dekes, overall great speed, plays at a high level, someone that not only has good speed, but skates and shoots at that high speed, able to shoot at top speed. So really the Jack Hughes comparison makes a lot of sense with Patrick Kane. While Hughes is that center, he understands the wing mentality. He's able to play at that position in terms of being that playmaker, being that sniper, being that goal scorer, but also coming back and being able to play the transitional zone, allowing the game to fully come full circle for him. So a very similar comparison there. And what team would do best drafting Jack Hughes? Well, by the time this video is published, the lottery will only be within a couple hours. Or if you're watching this on the replay, the lottery may have already happened, and if so, I'll have a video already talking about the lottery. But Jack Hughes, until we know that, well, we see that the first overall pick currently is a Colorado Avalanche in terms of best odds. Obviously, they would do very well with him in terms of having that dynamic of McKinnon and Hughes. The two very speedy centers would look very well together. But also with the Kings, the Kings definitely need that center moving forward. Anze Kopitar getting older, he's very much a two-way player. Add in an elite passer like Jack Hughes, it makes sense. The Devils, certainly with Nico Hischier, could be a great 1-2 for them. Definitely a lot of elite teams are built around with elite centers. Now, the Oilers are a team that would not necessarily need Jack Hughes. Certainly, he would be great for them, but already having Draisaitl, McDavid, and Nugent Hopkins, it's better to address the wing issues, and so Kaapo Kakko would be the way to go. But then when we look at teams like the Flyers, Ducks, Rangers, and the Red Wings, they definitely would like to have Jack Hughes. The Red Wings, having Larkin and Veleno, don't necessarily need Jack Hughes. Certainly would be great for them. But definitely the Ducks and the Rangers and the Flyers could certainly use Jack Hughes, as could the Canucks. But I really think the team that needs him the most is the Rangers, and that's because the Rangers really don't have a number one elite center. Zibanejad is definitely there. They also have Hedl. They also have Elias Anderson. But they don't have someone who's an elite number one franchise center. The Flyers could also use that after Shane Couturier, depending how Nolan Patrick continues his development. Myself, personally, I'm a Minnesota Wild fan, if you didn't know that. And so, obviously, I would like it if the Wild slid up and drafted Jack Hughes. I don't think it's going to happen. In all likelihood, it won't, so I'm not even hoping for it. But it definitely would be a decent pick for them as well. They need to continue to bolster their center group. It's an older group. But I really think the Rangers would be a great fit for him, as would the Red Wings. Even though the Red Wings already have Veleno, already have Larkin, they'd be able to definitely do some shifts, see what they can do there. You already have some great talented wingers. Or if the Red Wings slide up, would they take Kaapo Kakko? Also very likely. So thank you guys for watching. Comment below your thoughts. What team do you want Jack Hughes to go to? And do you think he's very similar to Patrick Kane, as I think so? Or do you think someone else compares to him better? What prospect would you like me to review next? Comment below your thoughts. And if you're checking out this video, make sure to check out my analysis of the lottery, if that's out already. And at the time I post this, it won't be out initially, but as soon as the lottery ends, the video will be coming out very soon after. So make sure to check that out. And I'll see you guys, of course, in the comment section. I'm so glad you guys are enjoying this content. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Of course, subscribe. Feel free to share these videos with anyone that you know might enjoy them. And I'll talk to you guys later.